Today I will show you the execution of lab programs in Visual Studio using C++ language. So in order to run your program, we require the library, the OpenGL library. So I have downloaded the file, the OpenGL file, and I will show you the files with you people. So this is the file, the OpenGL files, which contains the freeglut library and glueglut 1.11.0. So these two files and also the freeglut.dll and glue32.dll. These four files are needed to run your CG lab program. So I will share these files in the Moodle. So first of all, I will show you the steps how to include these libraries in Visual Studio. Then I will show you the running part. So first of all, I hope you will know how to install the Visual Studio and all right. Hello, in the last semester, you people have learned the .NET. In Visual Studio, you can run the program. So first of all, start the Visual Studio. Kindly mute the microphones. Kindly mute the microphones. I will start the Visual Studio. So I have installed the Visual Studio in my laptop. So in order to run this one, you must have Visual Studio. It may be an enterprise edition or a standard edition. So once you install, you open the Visual Studio either from the start button or you can go with the search. So I will start from here. Go to the Microsoft Visual Studio. So I am using Visual Studio 2015. So yeah, Visual Studio 2015. Now, okay, so this is the start page. This is the start page of your Visual Studio. You can create a project either from the file menu, file new, new project, or you can create from the start page itself. Here there is an option like new project. Just you click on the new project. Okay. Wait for a moment. I will click on new project. In the start page, just to click on the new project. So remember, in the Visual Studio, you select the language as Visual C++, and the template, it should be an empty project. In the template, you select an empty project, and the language we are working is C++, so hence it is Visual C++. Then the project is empty project. So once you select the project, by default, it will ask you the name of the project. By default, it will take the project number from starting from 1, 2, 3, 4, like that. So hence project 7. Previously, I have created the project 6. So you can rename the file, or you can keep as it is, the name project 6. Then it will ask you the location where you want to save the file. So by default, it will be in documents. Documents, Visual Studio 2015, then the project, then the solution name will be same as your project name. So hence it is project 7. So the language is Visual C++, and in the template you should select empty project. So then you click on OK. Now an empty project will be created. So the project has created. So once the project has been created, you should go to the Solution Explorer window. If this window is not visible, then you go to the View menu, then you select the Solution Explorer window. Solution Explorer window, I have created a Visual C++ project, but I have not added any source file. So now I will tell you how to add the source file. Just you right click on the solution in the Solution Explorer, right click on your solution name. The solution name is Project 7. Just you right click and go to add, then go to new item. So I wanted to add a C++ file so to my project. So for that one, I will be going to right click on your solution explorer, then go to add, then click on new item. So because I selected the project as C++, Visual C++, now by default I can add the C++ file or the header file, but I am adding C++ source file. So once I click on it, will ask you the name of the file. By default it is source.cpp. You can rename the file it as main.cpp, or you can keep at it as it is like source.cpp. Then click on add. A source file will be created. Yeah, you can make observation here. Previously the source file folder is empty. Now it is main.cpp. Are you following? Are people following right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So main.cpp. So I have created a source file, but I have not included any code in my file. So before going to include my code, so I will show you how to add the dependent libraries. The dependent libraries like OpenGL. I've shown you like the glut libraries and free glut libraries. So you should remember these steps. So I will tell you the steps how to add the dependent libraries. So already I have downloaded in my desktop. So I will, how to add means, just you click on the solution explorer again, right click on the solution explorer name, the project 7, then now you go to properties. So in the properties, in this dialog box, I should select the language here. You go to C or C++ language, C or C++. So in general, we'll be getting this information, include additional directories and all. So I have to include the additional directories to execute our C++ program in Visual Studio. So I'll be clicking on additional include libraries. So here I'll click on edit. So include additional libraries. I have to include the OpenGL library. So hence I'll be moving to the path where I have saved. So I have saved in desktop with the folder name OpenGL. So I'll be moving to that folder. So just you click on here, the new line, then the button here. So it will ask you where is that file. So I'll be moving to the desktop. Yeah, I think, yeah, it is working fine, good. Yeah. Yeah, desktop. In the desktop, I have a folder with the name OpenGL. So click on OpenGL. Here I have to select the free glut and view glut. So first I will go over to free glut. I have to include the libraries, go to free glut, then click on include, then you select the folder. This is what I did for free glut library. Similarly, you can do the same thing for view glut. So click on new line, then go to the desktop. In the desktop, go to OpenGL folder, then view glut, then include library. Then you select this folder. So this is, I have included the libraries with respect to C++ only. So then you click on OK. So once I include the directories, then I have to provide the linker. So for that one, I'll be moving to the linker section. In the same one, I'll be moving to the linker section. The linker section, I'll be going to the input. In the input, you have to give the additional dependencies, libraries like freeglut.dll and glueglut.dll. So for that one, go to input, then click on additional dependencies. Here in the additional dependencies, I have to add the library. So just you click on edit and you should give the file name. So in the OpenGL, we have given the file name like this is the file. The file name is freeglut.dll and the other file name is glue32.dll. So you should give these two file name in the linker section. So I will copy this file name. So I will copy this file name and paste it here. And paste it in the linker section like additional dependencies. So it is freeglut.lib. Then similarly, I have to give the another file name, that is glue32.dll. So I will copy that file and save it here, copy and paste it, and give the extension lib. So these are the additional dependencies you should do in the linker section. So once you do, then click on OK. So this is the additional dependencies I have given for. Then in the linker section, again you move back to the general section. In the general section, I have to give the additional library directories. In the additional library directories, you click on this one, go to edit, then you include the additional library directories. Again, you go to the desktop. I have saved the file in my desktop. So, desktop, then OpenGL, pre-glut, include. Sorry, library, additional libraries, lib. Okay, then one more. That is for pre-glut, desktop, OpenGL, glue, lib. Okay. Once you've done all these things, this is the configuration you must make before executing your lab program. If you miss any one step, your program won't get executed, right? So once you've done all this, then you click on apply. Then you click on OK. So I've created the additional library dependencies. Then I have to add the DLL files to my project. So again, I will go to the Solution Explorer. In the Solution Explorer, the solution name is Project 7. Just you right click and go to Open Folder in Explorer. Open Folder in Explorer. So these are the files associated with this project. In my project, these are the file associate. Main.cpp is the source file. This is the Visual Studio project. Here, you must copy the freeglut.dll and glue32.dll, the files here. So I will go to the OpenGL files and I will copy only the files freeglut and glue32.dll to my project. Yeah. Here it is. I have added. So suppose if it won't work, even you can make the dependencies are like the freeglut.dll and glue32.dll in system folder. So in system folder means just you go to the C drive, go to my computer. In the my computer, go to my computer, then in the C drive, you can move on to Windows folder, then go to system 32. Here you can copy and paste the freeglut.dll and glue32.dll. Because it is a directory, the operating system directory, it will ask you whether you wanted to save the file or not. So I'll be copying it because it is already existing. So it will ask you to whether we wanted to overwrite or rename the file. I will ask, put it as overwrite itself. Okay, then it has been copied. Right. These are the configuration you must make before executing your lab programs. Right. So okay. Then I'll be moving back to Visual Studio. Yeah. Here. Studio. So I have already added the dependencies and all. No, the next thing is I have to include the source code here. I have given the file name as main.cpp, but it is an empty. So for the time being, I will be copying the existing code. So that will also I will put it in the folder. Others kindly mute the phones. So I will open the windows.txt file. Just I will copy the existing code and paste it here. Just for the time being, I will copy and paste it here. So in the main.cpp, here you paste the code. Yeah. So this is a simple program which is going to display on window, right? The sample program. In the lab, we have explained like how to create a window. That is what I have copied the code here. So once you've done all the dependencies and all, the next step is to run the program. So in order to run the program, first you must build the solution. So build the solution, click on build menu and build solution. ಮನೋಜ್ ಕುಮಾರ್ ಮ್ಯೂಟ್ ಮಾಡಪ್ಪ ಮೈಕ್ರೋಫೋನ್. ಮನೋಜ್ ಕುಮಾರ್ ಯಾ, ಒನ್ಸ್ ಯು ಕ್ಲಿಕ್ ಆನ್ ಬಿಲ್ಡ್ ಮೆನು, ಇಫ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಎನ್ ಎರರ್ ಇಟ್ ಶೋಸ್ ದ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಎರರ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ನೋ ಎರರ್, ಸೊ ಹೆನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಲ್ಡ್ ಸಕ್ಸೀಡೆಡ್. ಸೊ ಒನ್ಸ್ ದ ಬಿಲ್ಡ್ ಸಕ್ಸೀಡೆಡ್, ದೆನ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ರನ್ ದ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್. ಸೊ ಪ್ರೆಸ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ F5 ಆರ್ ಯು ಕ್ಲಿಕ್ ಆನ್ ಲೋಕಲ್ ವಿಂಡೋಸ್ ಡೀಬಗ್ಗರ್ ಎನಿ ಒನ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್. So the loading symbol for project exe.dll, then the symbol files. Now and window has been created. This is the output, right? So this is what we got in the lab, right? While executing the sample program, we have explained like how to create a window. The same output you are getting, right? Hello, I hope you people are following, right? And this is the step you must follow to execute your lab set program. So all the lab set programs are uploaded in Moodle. So now you can execute the lab set program either by using the Visual Studio, or you can use CodeBlock, or you can use any online editors. So you can do it. So if you wanted to do it in Visual Studio, you must follow this step. I will share you the files. Those files are important, the freeclut and glue32.dll files. And the steps you must follow. If you miss any steps, you won't get the execution. So any doubt here? Hello? Guys, any doubt? Hello?
No, sir. No, sir.
Okay, fine.
Sir, even in sir code blocks are made easy, hello, sir. In a Visual Studio, in a
yes, you can do it. Code block are made up of Visual Studio, not made. But it is up to you people. But you are running environment go there before. Because in the lab we are all running in Windows XP, but if you wanted to install in Windows XP, then we have to install virtual machine, like install markup, VMware markup, enable markup. So because in system you learnt .NET, right? I hope you matter all Visual Studio idea and but na I have explained these things. Otherwise you can do it in CodeBlock itself.
Okay, sir.
It is not mandatory like you must execute in Visual Studio itself. Atharanella any running environment. And in the lab also, you people have the lab internals. In the lab internals, you must execute the program in this way. If you wanted to do it in CodeBlock, you can show it in CodeBlock. Adalara run made, idalara run made. Anything will be okay. But you must be aware of the steps, how to run and how to add the dependence libraries. That is important. The same output, what you got in the lab, the basic OpenGL window. Okay. Will it be okay, or do you have any doubts?
No, sir.
Okay, fine. Okay. And already we have uploaded all the programs in the Moodle. Both A section and B section student can able to access the programs. So now you can run your programs in Visual Studio itself or CodeBlock. Yavudellara run maadi, but every programs, ella programs execute maadi kodi. So maybe in the next week you have the lab internals. We'll post you in the WhatsApp group at what time you have the lab internals and all. And also one more thing, your CG lab project. So you must give the demo like this. You must give the demo because you people have already made the project mates, right? So the two project mates has to give the demo of execution of your project. I mean to say the flow, how it will be executing and all. Right. So we'll be doing the two internals, one for the project, another for the lab set program. others, any doubts?
Sir, laptop ಇಲ್ದರು
ಲ್ಯಾಪ್ಟಾಪ್ ಇಲ್ದಲ್ಲಿ ಇರೋ ಆನ್ಲೈನ್ ಎಡಿಟರ್ಸ್ ಯಾವ್ದ್ರಲ್ಲಾರು ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ರಪ್ಪ. ಲ್ಯಾಪ್ಟಾಪ್ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಮೊಬೈಲ್, ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟ್ ಟು ರನ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಮೇಕ್ಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಲೈಬ್ರರೀಸ್. ಲೈಬ್ರರೀಸ್ ಬೇಕೇ ಬೇಕು. ಲೈಬ್ರರೀಸ್ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇಟ್ ವೋಂಟ್ ವರ್ಕ್. ಸೊ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಗೆಟ್ ಆಕ್ಸೆಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಯುವರ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್. ಯಾರ್ತನ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಹತ್ರ ಶೇರ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಟ್ರೈ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು. ದಿಸ್ ನೋ ಅದರ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್. ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಸಿ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಜಾವಾ ಆರ್ ಪೈಥಾನ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಡೂ ಇಟ್ ಆನ್ ಮೊಬೈಲ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ರನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು. ಬಟ್ ಕಂಪ್ಯೂಟರ್ ಗ್ರಾಫಿಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟ್ ಟು ಪ್ರೊವೈಡ್ ದ ಲೈಬ್ರರೀಸ್, ಡಿಪೆಂಡೆಂಟ್ ಲೈಬ್ರರೀಸ್. ನಾನು ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಬ್ಲೂ ಗ್ಲಟ್ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಫ್ರೀ ಗ್ಲಟ್, ಈ ಡಿ ಎಲ್ ಎಲ್ ಫೈಲ್ ಸಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅವರ್ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್. ಈವನ್ ಯೂಟ್ಯೂಬ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಲ್ಯಾಪ್ಟಾಪ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ಸ್ ವಿಡಿಯೋಸ್ ಹಾಕಿದೆ. ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಆಕ್ಸೆಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ. ಈವನ್ ಸ್ಟಿಲ್ ವಿ ಹಾವ್ 3 ಮೋರ್ ಲೆಫ್ಟ್. ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಅಪ್ಲೋಡ್ ಸೂನರ್. ಓಕೆ, ವಿಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಬಿ ಓಕೆ ಆರ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಮೀ ಟು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಟೈಮ್? ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಎನಫ್, ರೈಟ್? ಎನಿ ಡೌಟ್ಸ್?
ಸರ್, ಈಗ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಮಾಡಿದಿರಲ್ಲ ಸರ್, ರೆಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಮಾಡಿದಿರಲ್ಲ, ಅದನ್ನ ಕಳಿಸ್ಬಿಡಿ ಸರ್.
ಓಕೆ, ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಶೇರ್ ಯು, ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಶೇರ್ ಯು ದ ರೆಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಅದನ್ನ ಶೇರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ. ಅಂಡ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್, ಇನ್ ಯೂಟ್ಯೂಬ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ವಿಡಿಯೋಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಕೋಡ್ ಬ್ಲಾಕ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ರನ್ ಮಾಡೋದಾಗ್ಲಿ ಆರ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಮೇ ವಿತ್ ದ ವಿಜುವಲ್ ಸ್ಟುಡಿಯೋ, ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಎನಿ ಒನ್.
ಓಕೆ
ಸರ್. Will this be okay, right? Yeah. Thank you, guys. Thank you for joining the session. Please be online. If anything information, Mahesh sir will convey you. Please be online. Thing I wanted to convey you people, right? You must write the record, all the programs in your records, all the programs, and you must send the scanned copies. Ella programs have birth, but with output you should send it to our mail IDs, individual mail IDs, kalsi, so that we can save the information. Okay, fine, right? Internals can tell us for internals it is mandatory to run the programs. ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ಸ್ ರನ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಪ್ರಾಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಯು ಶುಡ್ ಗಿವ್ ದ ಡೆಮೋ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್. ಜಸ್ಟ್ ನೀವು ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೆಡಿ ವಿತ್ ದ ಎನ್ವಿರಾನ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್, ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಯು ಶೋ ದ ಡೆಮೋ ಹೌ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ವರ್ಕಿಂಗ್, ಹೌ ಯು ಆರ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟೆಡ್ ದ ವಿಂಡೋಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್. ಓಕೆ, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಗಾಯ್ಸ್, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಫಾರ್ ಜಾಯ್ನಿಂಗ್ ದ ಸೆಷನ್. ಐ ವಿಲ್ ವೈಂಡ್ ಅಪ್. ಎನಿ ಇಶ್ಯೂಸ್? ಓಕೆ, ಫೈನ್. I will end the session. Thank you. Thank you for joining the session.